high definition tonight at 7 on Wish TV.
Downtown Lexington, Kentucky, Rupp Arena, 22,000 plus to see. Dark horse Kent State, the number 10 seed against number 5 seed Indiana. Conqueror of Duke on Thursday night, the Hoosiers seeking a 6th national championship. Oklahoma meets the winner next Saturday in the national semifinals. All the teams playing tomorrow are 1s and 2s. Oklahoma is number 2, so this game will produce a team that will be the champion of those that love the underdog, Matt Gukas.
Well, Kent State here, and they are not your everyday number 10 seed. They think they belong here, and of course that's half the battle. And with Indiana, the big question is, how are they going to react coming down from the biggest win of their lives over Duke on Thursday night?
Well, they'll have plenty of support. This 22,000 audience is about 5/6 in favor of Indiana. It's a sea of red and just a patch of gold. Gates, Gerwig, Shaw, Mitchell, Huffman, the leading scorer for Kent State. Jeffries won Big Ten Player of the Year as a sophomore. Odell, Hornsby, Coverdale, and Fife. Those three are sharpshooters from outside. The referees are Thornley, Whitehead, and Nunez. The home court of the University of Kentucky. It's Kaywood's court, named after Kaywood Ledford, the famed broadcaster of Kentucky for so many decades. They met last year. Kent State shocked Indiana, 77-73. And that may work in the Hoosiers' favor in trying to get themselves back up. They left San Diego, a pained Big Ten team, and they know that Kent State is good enough to give them a tough go tonight. Odell moves outside. This is Hornsby. Mitchell on him. Into the All-America Jeffries. Clears it out and stolen. Andrew Mitchell. And this Kent State Golden Flash team showed three very top-notch programs, Oklahoma State, Alabama, and Pittsburgh, that they can defend the ball.
Well, when we talked to Stan Heath, the coach of Kent State, yesterday, he wasn't quite sure how they were going to defend the post. They showed right away. Come down and double team.
Trevor Huffman on cue. The star guard, the senior from Petoskey, Michigan, hits a three, and Kent State leads 3-0. Coverdale will watch his ankle. He's been laboring. Ooh, a near steal by Demetric Shaw, and that leaves Fife open for the three, and Dane Fife ties it up.
Both teams very confident from the three-point line. The way Duke played it the other night, they did not want to give the Indiana perimeter players any kind of looks from beyond the arc, and they were willing to give up a lot of inside stuff to Jeffers, but Indiana didn't go to it early.
Inside Antonio Gates, he's listed at 6'5", the big body, and he was the star in the win on Thursday night. Demetric Shaw is short, and Odell rebounds for the Hoosiers.
Dane Fife, the co-defensive player of the year in the Big Ten, always draws a tough assignment. Gates will be that.
And Dane Fife nails another three from the corner. 6'3", Indiana.
And Dane Fife's got to feel like he was let out of jail after being bailed out by Jason Williams, missing that free throw that could have tied the game up, and who knows what after that. What a sigh of relief for Dane Fife.
In the corner, to Shaw on the point. Huffman being tacked by Coverdale as he tried to work a screen, and Mitchell fires a three. He's been cold from outside, and it's Fife with the rebound. Here come the Hoosiers. Coverdale with a hesitation on the dribble, and the block will be called against Huffman of Kent State. Stan Heath in his first year at Kent State, 30 wins, most ever by a Mid-American team, a protege of Tom Izzo at Michigan State, and Mike Davis, who took over from Bob Knight a year ago, has a 4-year contract and has really answered his critics with the performance of his Hoosiers in this tournament.
Well, so far, Indiana not showing any signs of a hangover from the win the other night. Shooting it brilliantly from the perimeter. Normally, Kent State is up and defends that very well.
Kyle Hornsby and Dane Fife, 3-for-3 from three. Mitchell pulls up for a 15-footer, won't fall. Gates can't tap it. Jeffries the rebounder. Leads Indiana in scoring and rebounding. The
Thus far, the Hoosiers have been able to find the open man for good looks from outside the arc. Coverdale sets up Ogle, the big man. Fahey hits one. 4 for 4 on three-pointers. Stan Heaton, time out. Vice 2, Hornsby 1, Ogle 1, 12-3 Indiana.
Oh, yes! Yes!
Want happy employees? Help secure their financial futures. At the Principal Financial Group, that's what we do. The Principal is the 401k leader. Financial solutions for you and growing businesses. The Principal Financial Group. We understand what you're working for.
Well, terrific execution on the part of Indiana on the underneath. Andrew Mitchell getting hung up on the screen. Kyle Hornsby at 43% on the year. And this is set up beautifully on the penetration by Tom Coverdale. And a guy that rarely shoots the three-pointer, Jared Odell, coming into this game on the year, just 2 out of 7 from beyond the arc. Everybody brought their shooting shoes here tonight.
They're only 2 for 10 against Duke Thursday night, and a perfect 4 for 4 to open this one. Gates with Fife, voted the Big Ten Defensive Player of the Year. Underneath the Gates, didn't walk, and the foul is called. Yeah, one of the moves made by first-year coach Stan Heath was to send in his experienced senior sixth man, number 40, Eric Thomas, who played so well off the bench in the win against Pittsburgh on Thursday night. Odell picks up the foul, his first. Antonio Gates, quite a story, went to Michigan State on a football scholarship. Heath wanted him as an assistant to play basketball as well. Had trouble with his studies, has bounced around, and finally said, I'm mature enough to understand I need to graduate. I need an education. Decided to come to Kent State not only because of Heath, but because Aronde Taliaferro, his high school coach in Detroit, is an assistant coach at Kent. Had a chance to go to Fresno State.
Dick, I thought he showed a lot of that maturity the other night on a very controversial call late in regulation. He powered through a defender, made the basket. It was taken away. Stan Heath was livid, but all the players looked at him, including Gates, and don't worry about it, coach. We'll get him in overtime.
Jeffries gets the freshman Gerwig in the air, and that'll be a foul on him. Non-shooting.
Gerwig, that'll be his first. And the team
Jeffries, who struggled with a bad ankle all through the Big Ten season, but seems to be getting better with each game, and he certainly showed that against Duke.
Oh, we see a very small team in Kent State. They just got a lot bigger with John Edwards, a 7-foot sophomore from Hudson, Ohio. Gives them a presence in and around the basket where maybe they don't have to come out, double team, worry about the interior so much instead of giving up those outside threes.
Jeffries working on Gates, and it's going to be charge, a little too much bump from Jeffries. No, they're going to say that's traveling. Here comes Trevor Huffman, and the Kent State flashes down 12-4 early.
Now, other than Antonio Gates, Kent State does really not have a low post presence, and many times he prefers to get the ball out on the wing. They've got to create their openings with dribble penetration usually, but they've had good luck putting the ball in Gates' hands.
Hornsby on the backside of Gates, able to create the steal. And he'll fire another three. Oh, my! 5 for 5 from three-point range.
And Dick, you can just see the rhythm out there right now. Indiana clicking on all cylinders, able to get those little half penetrations, and what that does is draw the defense just enough, sucks that in a little bit, and then the outside shooters getting their feet set.
Mitchell with a very tough drive. And a foul. It's as if Odell is going to pick up his second. No, it's going to be Hornsby, his first.
Here's that little penetration there, and actually nobody with Hornsby there getting inside is Eric Thomas falling asleep defensively. As I said earlier, normally Kent State up on those outside shooters, and Andrew Mitchell shooting the ball brilliantly from the line, stealing balls, getting assists, but just cannot shoot the ball from outside. 0 for 14 in the tournament from beyond the arc.
Mitchell, one of two players from Detroit, and of course Heath was a high school player in the Motor City. An outstanding football player as well, an all-stater, quarterback. They say he can throw the ball 65, 70 yards
on the floor.
Timeout. The Hoosiers jump out to a 9-point early lead.
Agile all-wheel drive Saturn View, at home in almost any environment.
Brown loves the chase. Brown tells me exactly when our customers receive their shipments. Brown tracks down the names, and that lets me bill faster. Brown helps me shake the money tree. Brown makes my job kind of fun, in a dead serious sort of way.
Get paid faster. What can Brown do for you?
All right, whichever one of you guys picked that VanderTech stock, thank you for the new boat I bought this weekend.
Boat? Nice.
Rick, is that you?
No, wasn't me. Maybe it was Kowalski.
No, it was Fisher.
Fisher.
Fishnet.
What?
Good call on that VanderTech stock.
Did I pick that one?
Come on, Fish. Come on.
Yeah, what do you got?
The new E-Trade. More of what you need to stay ahead in today's economy. E-Trade Financial.
Wow. That is so cool.
Can he do it again?
Sure. Go get one, boy.
Okay, so where does he get them?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Get down!
Great taste that won't fill you up and never lets you down.
Ooh, that's a first.
Make it a Bud Light.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Mazda MPV, UPS, E-Trade Financial, and by Bud Light.
The new courthouse in Lexington, this unique perspective, a courtesy of Saturn and the Saturn Lightship. Saturn and its retailers hope you enjoy the game and the view. Indiana with the ball in a 15-6 early lead. Nearly 5 minutes gone in this opening half. Jeffries, does he save? No. Thomas for Kent State to Mitchell.
Good interior defense by Antonio Gates, giving up about 4 or 5 inches in there, but certainly not in strength, able to muscle Jeffries out of the low block.
Mitchell struggles to score continue for Kent State. Indiana, as they bring the ball up court, the Hoosiers have tried 5 shots, all 5 from 3-point range, and you see they made all 5. They haven't even attempted one inside the arc.
And the only field goal for Kent is a 3-pointer as well. But you can see Indiana is trying to get the ball inside to Jeffries. It was kind of a pick-your-poison situation for Kent State. Do we stop the perimeter guys, get up on them, or do we stop the inside? And evidently, they're more worried about the inside and leaving the outside shooters, I wouldn't say wide open, but they're really not being challenged enough.
Finally, a 2, and that's 8 points for Holmesby. And the Indiana team has yet to miss a shot. 1 for 6 for Kent. Gates working on Fife. Thomas Huffman passes back in to Gates, takes it up, and the rebound, Jeffries.
A good ball movement and a high percentage shot, but there's some tall timber inside there to bother shots, and that's another big advantage for Indiana against State. Oh. Shot blocking ability.
Edwards able to block Odell's attempt.
As he said, the leading shot blocker for Kent State is John Edwards. That's just his 24th on the year.
Mitchell out and Demetric Shaw returns. He was voted the conference top defensive player. And Jeffries with the easy basket inside. So there's the poison interior.
It's two times now Kent State has fallen asleep. Very lax in their defense against underneath out-of-bounds play. Normally, most teams very well prepared for that. Kent State clearly very lethargic right now.
Thomas, the senior, well off the mark from three. Over with a rebound. The Indiana fans love this. They're on the attack again with a 19-6 lead. Yet to miss a shot. 7 for 7. 5 of those from outside the arc. Fife. Odell. The first miss. Dimitri Shaw sends Huffman to the offensive end.
One thing about Kent State, however, they have gotten behind in games, obviously, during the season. They really have a lot of poise. You cannot discount the fact that they have senior leadership. These guys have played together, been around along. Keep an eye on Jared Jeffries and then Eric Thomas, as we saw him fall asleep last time on the out-of-bounds play underneath. Once again, getting caught on the screen, and he's coming off a terrific performance. He's helped Kent State knock out Pittsburgh on Thursday.
Coverdale with a blocking foul is first on the Huffman drive. Dame Fife now on Thomas. And Coverdale covering Huffman.
Coverdale's going to try to stay up on that right hand. He knows Huffman wants to do that. Cross over and go back to his right. Indiana well prepared for that.
Long cross-court pass. Thomas is short. Gates gives Kent State another chance, and he takes it inside and scores. Antonio Gates, three for him.
He likes that little move when he goes to his right. He likes to feel bodies and able to duck back in underneath. He certainly has skills that belie his wide body. Very agile.
Inside to Jeffries. Can't hit. And he's out of bounds trying to save it. Kent State the other way.
Take a look at Antonio Gates there. Even though two bodies in front of him, he's able to make that wide body very, very slim and somehow or other slither through.
Coach Dan Heath brings back Mitchell and gives Huffman a breather. And we see Jeff Newton, number 50, the first time for Indiana. He's a shot blocker, rebounder. He had 8 points and 10 boards against Duke.
Indiana is an outstanding defensive team. They hold their opponents during the year to just about 60, 62 points a game. Very good on the perimeter as far as taking away penetration. And that solves you a lot of problems at the defensive end.
Newton with a reach in his first foul for Indiana. It is their fourth team foul. Kent State with two. Following each game, log on, get updated tournament brackets at CBS. Or on America Online, enter keyword CBS Sportsline. Edwards ruled in the act of shooting. Misses the first free throw. He's 2 for 3 on the season on average.
Originally a walk-on for Kent State, has earned a scholarship, and this is sophomore year, mainly because he's 7 feet, can block a couple of shots, and they need size.
Good connections at Kent State. Both of his parents are former Kent State professors. 1 out of 2 for Edwards. Indiana's lead is 10.
The new Saab 9-5. With a more solid ride and a turbocharged engine you can't wait to take advantage of.
Yeah, you know,
can I try the red one again?
Oh.
Right now, lease a Saab 9-5 linear sedan starting at $399 a month for 36 months. For details, see your Saab dealer.
Now you can get the Pizzone Power Pack from Pizza Hut. Woo! Your choice of Pizzone, the pizza you eat like a sandwich. A 2-liter Pepsi and 5 breadsticks for $8.99. Now that's a meal deal big enough for two. Bon appetit. Maybe even more. Or you can add another Pizzone. This is big. I don't know if you can handle it. For only $5. Pizzone good. The Pizzone, Pepsi, and breadsticks for only $8.99. Enough food to make other value meals run and hide like little frightened snacks.
Help us!
Pizzone Power Pack from Pizza Hut.
Ultra powerful, ultra easy. That's new Lotrimin Ultra, the new athlete's foot cure. Why is it ultra powerful? It's got a new prescription strength ingredient. Why is it ultra easy? Because you just use it once a day. Ultra powerful, ultra easy. New Lotrimin Ultra.
Here at Pear Skating, Tom and Sue are on the ice.
And a crossover step. Very, very nice.
Now, is there tomfoolery coming up?
Yes, yes, there it is, tomfoolery. My, oh my.
Who would know they have arthritis?
Celebrex celebrates the Olympic spirit in all of us. Just one Celebrex can relieve the pain, inflammation, and stiffness of osteoarthritis for 24 hours. Celebrex should not be taken if you've had aspirin-sensitive asthma or allergic reactions to aspirin or other arthritis medicines or certain drugs called sulfonamides. In rare cases, serious stomach problems, such as bleeding, can occur without warning. Tell your doctor if you have kidney or liver problems.
And look at the score.
Ask your doctor about Celebrex, official supporter of the 2002 U.S. Olympic team.
10 years ago, Fred Couples hit his tee shot here at 12, and somehow it stayed dry on his way to the green jacket, a tradition unlike any other. The Masters on CBS.
Well, the senior from Clarkston, Michigan, Dane Fike, with a new lease on his basketball life. He got the Hoosiers flying out of the gate, draining three-pointers. He got the first two, and then Hornsby, and then over, and then Kyle Hornsby again, really putting Kent State on their heels as attacking from the perimeter.
Hoosiers making their first seven shots. The first five were threes. Coverdale's turn. He joins the three-point party.
So, hey, what about me? Knock him down from outside, too.
6 for 6 from outside the ring. And Andrew Mitchell needs an equipment timeout, official timeout to get that right shoe back on. It's the Hoosiers who are shooting out of their shoes.
Well, in the tournament so far, on average, Indiana's shooting just about 5 for 13, below their norm of the regular season. Duke the other night, but it was Duke's defensive strategy coming into that game. They wanted to shut down the three-point shooters, and then they were going to adjust to Jeffries as it dictated during the game. Of course, I don't think Duke ever really realized the game would turn out the way it was, winding down the stretch, but certainly Indiana didn't get the threes going in that one.
Trevor Huffman, leading scorer for Kent State, back on the floor. Stan Heath could ill afford to keep him on the bench as Gates. Boy, does he use his body well, and he's so quick with that first step.
And really, he's got a mismatch there on Dane Fife, who stands 6'4". Gates at 6'5", obviously only an inch taller, but...
Coverdale's open, another three. Automatic from three-point range. These red-hot shooting Hoosiers, 7 for 7.
And Stan Heath, the Kent State coach, just putting his head in his hands, shaking his head. Pretty much saying, wouldn't you know?
Andrew Mitchell with his first bucket. Indiana by a dozen as we approach the midpoint of this first 20-minute period.
And Andrew Mitchell has to get it going if Kent State is going to compete and have a chance in this game. His three-pointers are critical to the cause because he's doing all the other things, but along with Huffman, they need his outside shooting.
Edwards blocked, but in bringing his hand down, he also flipped Coverdale, and that'll send the junior from Logansport, Indiana, to the line.
Antonio Gates averages just under 16 a game. Got away with a little bit of a shove there. Fife doing the smart thing, just giving up on that one, giving him the easy one. And Tom Coverdale playing with a very sore ankle.
Noblesville, Indiana High School is the home base for Tom Coverdale. He asked me to say happy birthday to his cousin Michael Huber back there. And the cheers are for this man, A.J. Moye. He was the big spark in the win against Duke coming off the bench. He's been 8 for 11 from the floor. 8 for 8 free throw shooting. He's just been outstanding in the tournament. 27-13, all Indiana early.
Moving the ball well, but really nobody they feel comfortable dumping the ball down inside to. They keep moving away from Antonio Gates. That's the guy they got to get touches for.
And a foul as Newton out to hit the arm of Edwards, picks up his second. Monday on the Emmy Award-winning Late Show with David Letterman, don't miss the star of the new CBS hit comedy Baby Bob, Adam Arkin, plus music from Midnight Oil, your favorite, Matt. It's an all-new Dave Monday here on CBS.
You're checking up on me again.
Yeah, that's a good deal. CDs with you. Edwards now 1-for-3 from the line. Odell back in, Newton out with his two fouls. In case you're just joining us, the Oklahoma Sooners, number 2 in the West, have beaten Missouri 81-75. They've earned their trip to the Final Four and will meet the winner of this one. 27-14 Indiana.
And we'll see now if Kent State can take a little bit of edge with Newton out of the game. He is their best shot blocker. So Jeffries will get a couple here and there. Odell once in a while, but at least you're going in there. Not as good shot blockers, and you may get some fouls on Jeffries. Should attack the basket.
Odell misses. Jeffries keeps it alive, and what's the call? The officials look at each other. No word yet. Indiana gets the call. Splashes of yellow here and there, but this is a red-clad Indiana Hoosier crowd. And there's the Kent State section, but after that, you go around Rupp Arena, and it's almost all red. Fife to the baseline. Coverdale with Huffman. Nice move.
Bad ankle at all. Coverdale has
speed and quickness from Dave Fife, Tom Coverdale, and Kyle Hornsby, the three normal perimeter players, yet they find a way. They do it again with a lot of guile.
Well, that Duke win made a lot of believers out of Indiana fans. The doubters, some of those who didn't think Mike Davis could do it. Mitchell misses. Jeffries rebounds. And the Hoosiers putting on a show here in Lexington, Kentucky. Moye hawked by Dimitri Shaw, takes it to the hoop. My, oh, my, oh, my. Indiana 31, Kent State 14.
I think I said earlier about the jolt of energy that A.J. Moye brings.
Hitting the underside of the board, Dimitri Shaw and Odell. Rebounds for Indiana. Moye.
Listen up. Here's a new guy. His name is Lennox, and he can play. And he's going to make all you guys look better.
I hear practice is going rather well.
Yeah, new guy Lennox is working out.
Come on, Jeff. Come on up, Jeff. Ooh, don't
do that. By the way, what'd he cost?
Peanuts.
Why would anybody that good play for peanuts?
Loves the game.
I'm the opening man.
Well, A.J. Moye coming off the bench usually makes his presence felt at the offensive end, but getting offensive rebounds, but right out of the chute, getting a good drive to the basket. Now you see how excited he gets. And it seems like when you can get that first easy one to fall for you, the confidence really lifts as he knocks one down from the perimeter. A.J. Moye, every coach would love to have a guy like that popping off their bench. Has a terrific attitude as a
guard. Largest deficit for Kent State all season long, 16, the previous hole they had to dig out of, and a nice move inside has just entered the game. Brian Bedford, an outstanding student, sophomore from Racine, Wisconsin, made his first basket.
He's a high percentage shooter, 59%, and that's why he gets a lot of layups, doesn't take bad shots, but Huffman and Mitchell have to do more of that. Penetrate, take the ball hard to the basket, see what they can create.
Through the hands of Odell and picked up by Mitchell. Pulls up and much needed goal for Kent State with 7 minutes to go in the first half in Indiana. Biggest lead, 20 points. 75% and perfect from 3-point range, 8-for-8.
I said the rebounding would be a problem for Kent State, but the problem is Indiana's not missing any shots to rebound.
fight. The first time the Hoosiers have missed from three-point territory. Inside, and Gates with a basket. Back-to-back buckets for Kent State, and that gives their faithful.
IU, this will be your 32nd timeout.
Gates fighting his way in there, 34-20.
One particular day, as I was saying goodbye to a friend, I hugged him, and the passengers behind him saw me do that, and they asked me, well, aren't you going to hug us too? And ever since, I've been hugging people. I'm known as the hugger. When people board my airplanes, I hug them all. When you look at a person and you smile at a person, you make eye contact with them and smile, I think it's contagious. My name is Rufus D. Lovett. I'm a customer service representative with United Airlines. I'm just being me.
When Baby Bob speaks, America listens. Last week, over 15 million people saw the new hit comedy with a lot to say. Baby Bob, right after the King of Queens. Yeah. Dick Denberg, Matt Gukas, Armin Katayan with you from Rupp Arena in Lexington, Kentucky, where the Big Ten Hoosiers of Indiana putting on quite a shooting display, leading Kemp 34-20. And by the way, that last shot by Odler, foot was on the line, so they still haven't missed from three-point range. In for the first time is the freshman point guard, Donald Perry, number 12 for Indiana. He's on the far wing. Moye, Jeffries, Perry, that's Moye, well short, and finally Indiana coming down from that boiling range. Kent State shooting better as well now. Since a 1-9 start, they're 6-for-8.
Oh, now on the last couple of possessions in the half court, Trevor Huffman has made a conscious effort to drop his head, get into the lane, draw the defense, and then drop off for easy baskets.
Fife working on him, and Fife with a hand check, and that'll cost him the foul. And will be Indiana's sixth of the first half, 3 for Kent State. And a timeout. 5:49 left in this opening half. The Hoosiers by 14.
Stop for a quick bite. How you doing back here?
Let's see. No air conditioning, no stereo, no adjustable lumbar support. You tell me.
That's why I brought you this.
A Gateway notebook? With a DVD player?
Yep, but I put your favorite movie in.
True Grit?
You know it.
Take your time, cowboy.
Pepto-Bismol. It's first aid for heartburn, diarrhea, nausea, indigestion, and upset stomachs.
What's up?
From the twisted mind of director Danny DeVito.
Hey, it's Smoochie!
Comes a movie that critics are calling a manic, hilariously pitch-dark comedy. Death to Smoochie. Ah! Rated R. Starts this Friday.
This is a new Pontiac Vibe. What do you think of it?
Just stands out, yeah.
Yeah, dude, excited.
So what do you guys think of the inside of it?
It's iced out.
It's iced out?
Iced out.
Sounds cool, man.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Yeah, what is that?
It's a plug. You can plug in.
What? Put a blender, we can make smoothies.
But you want a smoothie?
What do you think of that? The little chrome, all chromed out.
What do you like about this Vibe?
There's a party in it.
Meet the new Pontiac Vibe, official vehicle for the NCAA Championships.
It's a full service show, Dave!
Dave?
Dave is your friend.
The first name.
Dave.
In late night television.
Your name comes up all the time.
Back with our summary as Indiana's 20-point lead carved to 14 with 5 minutes and change remaining in this first half. You know, the Hoosiers, they went in with hope, and that's a case of all 65 teams, but now there's belief in this Indiana camp, and the win against Duke, of course, inspired that, and then they come up and feed off that victory of the Blue Devils.
And it doesn't hurt when you come out and make your first 8 3-pointers. That'll build confidence right now, and they haven't really gotten to their offensive rebounding game.
Gates with Jeffries. 13 on the shot clock. Mitchell and Huffman outside. 10 now. Odell on Huffman. Thomas, a tough runner for the senior.
Yeah, gets good, tough, sticky defense by Indiana. Tough on the perimeter. Make sure that time they sent Trevor Huffman to his left. He is just too dangerous going the other way.
8-0 run for Kent State in the last 2.5 minutes. The full within 12. Jeffries goes down as Bedford working defensively against him.
And Jeffries trying to buy a call there. It's very physical with Bedford. That's the way he plays. And why not for Jeffries? Here's Eric Thomas on a tough shot there. Shot clock winding down, having to shoot a runner. We talk about not only the perimeter defense of Indiana, but their inside defense is good too. Jared Odell, who has struggled throughout the season, but has been improving. But Jared Jeffries, of course, Big Ten Player of the Year. Everybody looks at his offense, and it's very good because he scores inside. He can step out to about 17, 18 feet. He's a very good defensive player.
And a very good ball handler. They actually thought as a freshman they might use him as a big guard, a 6'9 guard. Coverdale 1 out of 2. Indiana's lead is 13.
Well, not only do they hold their opponent to about 60 points a game, it's down around 40% from the field, a good sign that it's good defense.
Huffman outside. E.T. Thomas cannot hit that one, and Jeffries hauls it down.
Defense much better now. Kent State, I may admit, been made believers that Indiana is certifiably hot from downtown, making sure they get up. Don't even let them get a look.
Now look at how they balance the floor and separate all those three-point shooters. Mike Davis said he learned that coaching 5 years in the CBA. And then the feed wide open is Jeffries.
Great points, Nick, and that's what they did. They spread it very nicely, got the defense not where they want to be because they're so worried about the three right now. And that opens the door for Jared Jeffries.
Huffman inside, and Bedford can't hit. Gates has it ring out, and Jeffries has the rebound, and he's fouled.
Well, the floor is really spread here, and Jeffries using his body very nicely to seal off Antonio Gates.
Brian Bedford with a foul. Timeout.
We're bringing this brand new car around today. It's called the Pontiac Vibe.
Sounds like a party wagon.
How you guys like it?
I love it. It's
yeah?
It's pretty fat, dude. Yeah?
It's a fantastic car.
I'm a vibe girl, yeah.
Big O's. Sweet. Look at that AC connection.
Yeah.
Awesome.
I can see it zooming around town.
This is the road trip mobile.
Look at this.
I like that. It sounds sharp.
I like the silver.
Control. Circles.
They're built real tight, you know?
This is my kind of ride.
Meet the new Pontiac Vibe, official vehicle for the NCAA Championships.
In and out.
Good.
Keep the victim calm.
One and two and three.
Okay, there you go. It's over 130 channels, sports, news, entertainment, even your local channels, and it's only $39.99 a month.
Just $39.99 a month. Over 130 channels of DirecTV programming, even your local ones. Now get a DirecTV system for $49 or less, installed.
So it was the digital music that...
Yeah.
Clean it.
Is there a problem, Davey?
Well, Dad, there was only one Dew left. Tommy said it was his, I said it was mine, and we began to fight, and it was wrong. We're sorry.
Boys, why don't you give me the Mountain Dew? Ooh, ooh, ooh. Now let that be a lesson to you.
What just happened here?
We got hosed, Tommy. We got hosed.
Oh, Davey.
Introducing a whole new Energizer Max. With so much extra power inside, it's the longest-lasting Energizer Max ever. Do you have the bunny inside?
Why do I rent from Enterprise?
For more cargo room. More people room.
Or more headroom. Enterprise. So easy, it's like having a second car. Or third.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Get your tournament info and check out the road to the Final Four delivered by UPS at cbs.sportsline.com or on America Online. Enter keyword CBS Sportsline.
Armagatan back here in Lexington. It certainly appears the Hoosiers have taken Mike Davis's pregame motivational speech to heart. He talked about opportunity, the opportunity to erase the feelings they felt last year watching Kent State celebrate after that first round loss in the tournament, and the opportunity to go where only four teams are allowed, the Final Four. And so far, Dick, they certainly have seized that opportunity.
Oh, boy, Armin, thank you. And there's another punctuation point from Tom Coverdale. A three again, 14 points for him, and back to an 18-point lead. 9 for 10 from three-point range.
On the season, Indiana from three-point land shoots 7 for 18, 39%, which is very good. 9 out of 10 over the top.
Huffman can't hit the three, capped out by Gates. Beautiful move, but Coverdale able to deny. And here's Perry on a three-on-one, up to Odell. And Mitchell able to defend. Good job by Andrew Mitchell to get back.
Outstanding defensive play by little Andrew Mitchell at about 5'10", using his body very well.
In there with the big threes, and then a 10-footer for Gates. Well, done by Mitchell's pass. 9 for Gates to lead Kent State. Indiana has shot 50% or better in all their tournament games. When they beat Utah by 19, that was the warning bell for the rest of the teams in the brackets that the Hoosiers were ready. Then they defeated UNC Wilmington. Of course, the big upset of Duke on Thursday night, and then the hot shooting start tonight. Coverdale way outside. He's stealing it, but off the mark. Mitchell rebounds. Gates, ball away. And a push underneath. It'll go against Odell of Indiana, I believe.
Take a look at how wide the court is spread for Indiana. Little screen there set by Jared Jeffries. And I think throughout this whole first half, Kent State has been very slow on the few times. It's been about three or four times that they've had to chase around screens, but not coming out hard enough. You've got to get right on the hip of that offensive player, especially with a team like Indiana shooting the ball the way they are right now.
Odell given a rest with two fouls, and George Leach, the tallest Hoosier at 6'11 from Charlotte, North Carolina, number 5, is in the ballgame. And Dimitri Shaw is first point of the night. This young man playing for Stan Heath, two-time MAC Defensive Player of the Year. He was the Kent State homecoming king this past year. They're just hoping they'll be able to find a prince to play that Cinderella courting role and go on to Atlanta.
Kent State's goal here, just under 2 minutes to go in the half, is hang. And by that, I mean stay in the game. Stay close. No mental errors at this point. Try to get it to 10 if you can.
Almost a steal by Dimitri Shaw. In fact, Dane Fife said that Dimitri Shaw is the toughest defender he's had to work against all season long, going back to last year.
A lot of people would say that. He really gets after you. You can see right there up on Coverdale. And that's a good guy to put him on to try to stop that.
Oh, Jeffries and Leach miss. It was Leach who had a great chance on the follow. And here's Mitchell flying to the other end, but he got caught in the air, gets it back, and misses the shot. Gets it back again. What quick hands for the little guard from Detroit, Michigan. And then he throws a bad pass. The big man couldn't reach down and get it. Edwards. Coming up on Singular at the half, Greg Gumbel, Clark Kellogg back in New York to talk with Kansas coach Roy Williams. And you'll hear from those victorious Oklahoma Sooners, first team into this year's Final Four. This is the most points allowed in a first half all season long by Kent State, 40. They trail by 14 as we approach the 1 minute mark in this first half. Coverdale. Leach kept it alive on one bat, but Gates brings it down.
That's usually a good play for Indiana. Even though it looked like a wild shot, they just want to get it up on the glass where Jeffries and Leach can kind of volleyball it with one another.
Interesting matchup. You got Jeffries on the 6'3", Dimitri Shaw at the moment. Leach comes out to haunt Huffman. Huffman to Edwards. Well, they found the big man. He was guarded by the smaller Hoosier.
A terrific release on that shot by Edwards, but every time Trevor Huffman is permitted to go to his right hand, he generally makes something good happen for himself or for a teammate.
Oh, a timeout with 26 seconds left in this first half.
It's time to spring into action at your Honda dealer. Spring into the saddle of any Honda CR, XR, or ATV and ride off with 6.9% financing and no down payment. Or pay as little as $69 a month on a new ATV with your Honda card. Act fast and get a bonus. Get up to $300 in bonus bucks before March 31st. Spring into action now at your Honda dealer.
Saturday night in the Commonwealth of Kentucky and Indiana, the neighbors to the north with a 40-28 lead over 10th seed Kent State. The Hoosiers red hot from outside the arc, building an early 15-4 lead, then to 34-14, 20 points. Kent State has cut into that advantage. It's now a 12-point lead in the final seconds of the half. Odell, he walked with it, got away with it the first time, but not the second. So Kent State, with 10 seconds left on the clock, with a chance, get it to 10, maybe 9. That would be emotionally give them a lift going into the locker room.
And they desperately need it, and they feel they will have escaped something, given the way Indiana has shot the ball from the arc.
Huffman forced to take a shot a little outside his range and disappointed. Head down, he walks off. Tom Coverdale with 14, Hornsby with 8 for Indiana. Gates, Antonio Gates with 9, led Kent State in this first half. And the big story, three-point shooting, Indiana 9, 4-11. 40-28 for the cream and crimson Indiana Hoosiers, who shared the Big Ten title. Let's go to Armin Katayan.
Coach, a red-hot shooting start, but are you concerned your team got a little lackadaisical here towards the end?
Well, we start playing a little selfish, start forcing shots. We don't need to force shots because we're bigger than they are. All we need to do is just really take our time and go inside and pass the ball back out. We're wide open.
All right, Coach, thank you.
So the end of the first half, Indiana 40, Kent State 28. CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship continues after this message.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Pontiac, DirecTV, Mountain Dew, and by Enterprise Rent-A-Car.
Got a little too much hoops on your mind? Make a fast break to your nearby Mitsubishi big screen dealer. Get yourself a brand new Mitsubishi big screen HD TV. Mitsubishi.
Come on, you can do it. Just 30 seconds of Listerine, twice a day. Sure, it's a little intense, but think of all the germs you're killing. Listerine even kills the germs that can cause plaque and the gum disease gingivitis. That's right, you're fighting plaque and gingivitis every time. Keep it up, keep it up. Don't wimp out now. There, see, you can handle it, germs can't. Listerine, worth the time, every time.
Oh, come on, son, on you go. On you go. Come on, on you go.
Almost as kind.
There he goes, man. Something for that map's old scurvy shape.
Oh, he goes, failure.
A quiz going on here, he's up to 70, get a clue with it. Don't get as many wee broken bits as you've got there.
He's one of these orangutans, then.
Not orangutan, big man. Terengos,
not.
No. I'll take one anyways. I've got her in there. 800 now, not been one.
You don't have to understand these guys to understand new Terengos are great for dipping.
That is splendiferous, man. That is world class.
up to in those Old Navy legendary cargoes? Old Navy legendary cargoes. The best that legends are made of, with pockets to spare. There's a zip-offable, high-flyable, off-roadable, cliff-climbable way to get into and out of trouble. And rock-solid prices. Just $26.50 and up. They're not just cargoes. They're legendary cargoes. Only at Old Navy. You dig?
I think you should wear a tie.
Dad, nobody wears ties to school.
A tie says you're serious and it'll make a good impression. And remember, you're there to
make something of myself.
Almost half of all UNCF students are the first in their family to go to college.
And I'd make sure that I got my
lunch. Dad, you're not going. I am.
I know. And when you're the first to go, you're going for a lot of people. The United Negro College Fund. A mind is a terrible thing to waste.
Clark Kellogg in New York, coming up on Singular at the Half. The first team to get in is Oklahoma. We'll hear from some of the Sooners and watch them cut down the nets after this message and a word from your local station.
Hi, everyone. I'm back in town to get you on your feet again.
Get up.
What do you think, good offense or good defense? Pick one for a chance to win a Volvo S60 at volvocars.com/questions.
Long QT syndrome is an inherited heart condition that affects children and young adults. Symptoms range from fainting to cardiac arrest. Call to learn more.
From the directors of Top Gun and Black Hawk Down comes American Fighter Pilot from CBS Friday.
Over the last few years, has your individual retirement account fallen apart? The IRA experts at Strong can help put the pieces back together. They'll help you tailor your IRA to meet your retirement goals. And their unique one-stop service makes rolling over your existing IRA or 401k simple. Call 1-800-4-STRONG or visit us on the web at strong.com. You're one call away from a Strong portfolio.
My dream kitchen? That would be no kitchen at all. Since I am head chef, dishwasher, and laundry goddess, I want the best. And choices. Lots of choices. H.H. Gregg is so good about choices. Now, if I can only make up my mind.
H.H. Gregg has more choices than anybody. All at unbeatable low prices. H.H. Gregg, welcome to the revolution in choices.
Who offers a full line of financial products and services? Who provides personal, quality customer service? Who offers favorable rates with low or no fees? Who offers Saturday branch service and 24-hour online account access? Who can? The Financial Center can. The Financial Center, your source for financial services.
CBS Sports presents Singular at the Half, sponsored by Singular, the wireless company that supports self-expression nationwide.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to our New York studios and to Singular at the Half. I'm Greg Gumbel, along with Clark Kellogg, and our score at halftime in Lexington. Indiana leading Kent State by a score of 40-28. I made the comment a little while ago. You and I are the only ones that haven't hit a three in the first half, but it's tough for a team to keep this up.
It really is. They've made 9 of 11 and made their first 8. And in a game earlier this year, though, Greg, they made 17 in a win against Illinois. I don't think they can continue to shoot that way. But the problem for Kent is if they go out to the three-point shooters, then that leaves Jared Jeffries down alone inside where he can do some damage.
Well, the winner of this game goes to Atlanta, and there they will meet the Sooners of Oklahoma. The Oklahoma Sooners punched their ticket 81-75 over the Missouri Tigers.
Quanis White had a terrific game off the bench. Here he finds Hollis Price right at the end of the first half, 41-33 Sooners. But then Missouri's Ricky Paulding going to help ignite his team. Baseline drive. Watch him bounce and throw it down. 54-49 Sooners.
OU's Ebi Ara will take the cross-court pass here and hit the three. And the Sooners led 61-54. He had 17. Missouri's Arthur Johnson will feed Ricky Paulding, cutting down the lane for the dunk. But Oklahoma survived, ran away from the opposition, and Dan Bonner and Gus Johnson were with the winners.
think everybody just took up for each other. You know, we took the responsibility for Aaron and Jabari, all our big guys who was in foul trouble, and we pulled together.
And you guys also have a unique ability to play very tough and very hard nose on that floor.
Yeah, you're right. Kareem Rush started out great. You know, he went 4-for-4, and Coach got on us, and he said, we got to stop that guy. And, you know, we took it upon ourselves to stop him and stop the other guys also.
Missouri's a good team. They've had a great run. It's difficult beating a team that good twice in the same year, but we bent the day. They came back on us. We handled the foul trouble. We made some nice adjustments against what they were doing at times, but this is all about these kids, Dan. I'm so happy for them. They've worked so hard this year, and they deserve everything they get. They're going to the Final Four.
There's some things that are out of our control, and I felt that their hearts were huge, and they played for one another and competed as well as they have all year. And again, there's just some things that are out of our control, and there are a few things like that today.
As the Sooners celebrated becoming champions of the West, how about a word about the Missouri Tigers, Clark, and everything that Quinn Snyder said about his Tigers was right on the money.
Oh, yeah, I agree wholeheartedly. They had a terrific tournament run, showed what kind of team they could be when they played together and committed to defense and one another, and no reason for them to hold their heads down at all.
How well-balanced and well-equipped a team is Oklahoma going to Atlanta?
I tell you what, they've got a real shot because they defend. Their bench is strong. They're active and aggressive. They get timely shooting from a number of people, multi-pronged from the offensive end, and very aggressive and tenacious defensively and on the glass. Greg, that's a winning combination any way you look at it.
Hollis Price did what he was supposed to do, but look at the contributions from Quanis White, who had 12 points and 7 rebounds and 7 assists. They were all contributing to this Oklahoma victory. We'll be back on the road to the Final Four tomorrow at 2 Eastern time, followed by the Midwest Regional Final, Oregon against Kansas at 2:30 Eastern. And then at about 5 p.m. on the East Coast, UConn and Maryland meet in the East Regional Final. Speaking of that Oregon-Kansas matchup earlier, we spoke with Kansas coach Roy Williams, and I asked him if this Jayhawks team has performed to his expectations.
You know, I thought we had a chance to be very good, but if you had told me 32-3, I don't know if I could have said that. I knew how difficult the schedule was, playing Arizona, playing at UCLA. I'm very surprised and elated, to say the least, by this, but I've also been one of those guys, I never look down the schedule and try to determine what our record's going to be. And in the preseason, I thought if we really worked hard and got some breaks and things went our way, we would have a chance to be one of the best teams in the country, and I think that's what we are right now. We have a chance to be one of the best.
Roy, it's a quick turnaround for Kirk Heinrich, who suffered a sprained ankle. Could you give us an update on his status right now?
Well, I told him he should feel better today because he didn't play worth a darn last night. He kept getting in foul trouble, and so he rested. He only played 17 minutes last night, so I told him he should be really ready to go tomorrow. But the swelling has gone down and stayed down, but yet it is still sore. And again, I kidded him about it, but I'm hopeful that not having to play as many minutes last night will make him more effective tomorrow.
From pace of recovery, let's talk pace of game. When you look at this matchup on paper, it seems as though both teams want to get it up and down. Do you anticipate that the game will play out that way?
I really think that it will. I think that, you know, we average a lot of points. They average a lot of points. We love to run. They love to run. I don't think that Ernie or myself, either one, are going to try to make some tricky, you know, 1-1-1-1-1 defense or anything like that. I think we're going to try to go with our strengths. I can't speak for Ernie. You know, he may come up and outsmart me with something, but we want to run. And the problem that I have, and I hope that Ernie has it too, is my guys love to run, and I've got to make sure that they love to run back on defense, because that's what you have to do against Oregon as well.
You've talked about transition defense as a key against Oregon. Could you highlight anything else that's high on the priority list against them?
Well, one thing we want to do, we want to get our big guys involved in our running as well. We want to get the basketball inside and get those big guys involved with it, and we've got to make sure that we do that. And those three perimeter players from Oregon are so sensational, not only on the break of taking the ball to the basket, but pulling up to shoot the ball from behind the three-point line. So I think that's going to be my emphasis, to make sure we have five guys running both directions.
Roy, you've been deep into the tournament, you've been to a Final Four, you've been to a championship game, and there are people who are going to begin to wonder, well, when's Roy going to win the big one? Do you feel any of that at all?
I do some, because I really want to win one, but my relationship with my players is by far the most important thing to me. That's what I'm going to judge Roy Williams on, and yeah, I do hope we win a lot of games in that time period, too.
Kansas coach Roy Williams, thank you. You know, Kent State and Indiana have gone up and down the court pretty good in this first half. They may be slow motion compared to what we see between Oregon and Kansas.
This potentially could be as entertaining a game as we've seen in a long time. I think it could turn, though, on the front court play for either team and also bench play from both teams. I think the marquee guys may step up and step out, but front line play and bench play could make the difference.
All right, Clark, here's a question for you. Are you the most expressive college basketball fan? Enter to win Singular's most expressive fan promotion at Singular.com. You and a friend could win a trip to the 2002 NCAA Men's Final Four in Atlanta. Thank you for watching Singular at the Half. Dick and Matt will be back with the second half of Kent State and Indiana in a moment. Remember, the winner goes to the Final Four.
CBS Sports presents Singular at the Half, sponsored by Singular, the wireless company that supports self-expression nationwide.
Safety Triangle inspection and quality replacement parts like Monroe shocks and struts. Save up to $75 off Safety Triangle parts or service when you buy Monroe Reflex or SensiTrac shocks or struts.
That's a foul, player.
What? Get out of here, man.
That's the hack. My man got three signature moves. Hacking, hacking, and hacking. Whatever, though. If you quick, that fool ain't hard to shake. It didn't even matter that there wasn't a ref, because I had these, the Nike Air Flight Elevates.
You can't hack what you can't catch, right?
You can only get them at Foot Locker.
It's March Madness, Elite Eight, the Final Four. And what will you see on the courts? Nothing. Those who lose get nothing. Those who win, nothing. Because everyone on the court is drinking Aquafina. The numbers do not lie. Zip, zero, nothing. Only Aquafina makes nothing this pure and refreshing. Now that's a sixth man. Aquafina, riding the pine, is the official water for the NCAA championships.
Monday, the King of Queens has to pass a driving test.
I specifically took this job so I wouldn't have to read.
But will he crash and burn?
Heaven and...
Then catch the new hit comedy.
How about another?
With a lot to say.
Who the man? I am.
And all new Baby Bob. Next, Ray's wife is running for school president.
Your appearance reflects on me.
I didn't know it was going to be first lady.
And Greg's old flame is back in town with a shocking request.
Get Barnum and Bailey. This is going to be the greatest show on earth.
All new comedy. It's all here, CBS Monday.
Getting ready for the second half, 40-28 Indiana. For Indiana, its early big lead was as simple as 1-2-3. We'll return to Lexington after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Championship.
In 1935, Foxwood Farms started with one horse and a truck. The horse was a thoroughbred, the truck a Chevy Suburban. Today, they have a few more horses. But there's still only one truck, Chevy Suburban. With an available 8.1-liter Vortec engine, it's capable of towing up to 6 tons, making it the best Suburban yet. Chevy Suburban, like a rock.
Spirits are reaching out to one man, Ted Danson, Living with the Dead, CBS April 28th.
Now, during Spring Madness, get in a new Ford, because your Indiana Ford stores with great deals on America's number one choice. With Spring Madness, take up to $2,500 cash back or zero financing on F-150, or $1,500 cash or zero financing on Explorer and $2,000 on Ranger. The right deal now during Spring Madness, because we're with up to $2,500 cash or 0% from your Indiana Ford store.
In other news, it seems like another good day to be in the cigarette business. Stock prices are back. Manufacturers are rising ever higher. Today's jump in price comes on the heels of the top tobacco company reporting surging quarterly profits. It seems nothing can stop the money-making machine that is the tobacco industry. Such steady growth is a sure bet that tobacco will be going strong for many years to come. Something even the machine analyst asks, what is the secret to the tobacco?
What you doing?
Paying bills.
Paying bills?
Yeah, online with Forum.
Forum?
Yeah, you can pay bills, check balances, transfer funds.
I don't bank online.
Yeah.
What's that supposed to mean?
Forum. Your money, your voice.
Is IU headed to the Final Four? We'll have your post-game reaction Sunday on Daybreak.
On sale. Of course, your reaction may vary. Sears, national retailer of Mitsubishi projection TVs.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by Chevy Truck, The Hartford, the Intel Pentium 4 processor, and by Miller Lite.
Getting ready for the second half here in Lexington, Kentucky. Indiana led by as many as 20 in the first half. 12 points as we go to the second half as now we take a look at the Microsoft Agile move of the game. Indiana's Tom Coverdale, the agility of a running back finding a hole, driving and scoring. Now let's go to Armin Katayan.
Coach, how do you explain all the great looks Indiana got to knock down those threes, and how do you get Trevor Huffman into this game? He's just 2-for-5 from the field.
We had too many breakdowns defensively. We didn't do a good job in transition, communicating, finding our man. They had 27 points on three-pointers alone. And at the same time, on pin-down screens, we didn't do a good job of trailing. We gave up too much separation. We got to do a good job of getting Trevor back involved in this game. They're taking him out. They're denying him. They're making it tough. We got to set some screens, free him up a little bit so he can get some good looks.
All right. Thank you, Coach.
Dan Heath with a lot of problems to solve as we look at the numbers here in the first half, Matt.
Well, everybody's going to look to the three-point shooting. That is totally obvious. But look up to the left there, the 36% from the field for Kent State. Indiana is playing exceptional defense, playing very smart, containing the dribblers, especially doing a good job on Trevor Huffman. And even though Indiana only has one block shot in that first half, they must have changed about 7 or 8. Jared Jeffries playing outstanding D.
But there's some hope for the Golden Flashes and their fans as they were able to cut into that Indiana lead. They had a nice little 8-0 run, but they do need to get more scoring punch from not only Huffman, but the other guards popping outside, Dimitri Shaw and especially Andrew Mitchell, who continues to be icy in the tournament.
And Dick, I got to think Mike Davis talking to his team at halftime. He looks at his stats, his team shooting 58% from the field, the other team shooting 36, and he's only up by 12. And I'm sure he warned his team, do not fall in love with that three-point shot. It's been very good to us so far, but we have better ways to score. Make sure we go inside first.
That was the downfall of the Duke Blue Devils on Thursday night in the second half. Kent State will get the ball first. And as always, there's that double-figure deficit barrier they'd like to break through. Indiana did about 10 minutes into the second half against Duke, and that's when the fans, the emotion, returned for the Hoosiers. That's what Kent State needs to give their fans here perhaps early in this second half. Huffman, Gates, Shaw, Gerwig, and Mitchell, same five that started for Kent State. And the Hoosiers bring out their same starting five. Gates with fight. Uses his size, his girth, to maneuver and get that little five-footer.
Yeah, there's that mismatch. He has the strength and a little bit of height factor over Dane Fife, but Jeffries in the first half was able to help out on that a little bit.
Jeffries misses at the other end. Gates with 11 points to lead Kent State. He fires again. And it's Hornsby ripping down the rebound, sending Coverdale toward the other end.
Normally you would say too quick a shot there for Kent State. However, Antonio Gates can knock down that 17-footer. Normally has a very soft touch in that area.
Gerwig and Odell battling. On the lane, and batted away by Gerwig.
Odell, who got Indiana going in the second half against Duke, and came out and made his first five shots of the second half, scored 11 points in 5 minutes.
Kent State fans on their feet. They want a bucket here, get it into single digits. Well, they're going to say that Fife, as he fell down, the ball hit his foot and caromed out of bounds.
Well, Dane Fife, he's going to battle the small, quick guys. He's going to battle the big guys. He loves to play defense, and there's a major lip flop right there. If Antonio Gates ever really hit him, he'd go flying. That was a bag.
Huffman lost Coverdale for a moment, but Coverdale back to bat it away and thought he had knocked it off the leg of Trevor Huffman.
Of Coverdale and Fife and Hornsby, when they pick up Trevor Huffman out on the perimeter, they are so zeroed in on that right shoulder. They just do not want to let him go to his right.
Seven on the shot clock. Huffman into the lane and the ball away. And boy, he had to earn that one the tough way. It's down to eight.
And that's what you got to do. If they're going to take away your right hand, you got to make something happen going to your left. Huffman was good enough with that offhand.
Going back to the first half, a 10-point run for the Kent State Golden Flashes. The once 20-point lead, and let's call it as a hold against Andrew Mitchell. Go back to that tough two-pointer by Huffman.
He got bumped up on the right side, able to get loose there and then adjust in the air. Of course, we credit his good footwork to the fact that he was such a terrific soccer player as a kid growing up and in high school, but he got very strong legs and lift on his jump shot.
Led his high school team to the state championship. Almost a turnover. Jeffries there to scoop it up for Indiana.
Much more aggressive, lively defense on the part of the Kent State Golden Flashes coming out to start this second half.
Hornsby. Oh, it's a killer. You get a team fighting back, and then Hornsby and Fife. Coverdale hits that three.
Just takes the air right out of you after you've been aggressive in defense, work very hard, and then give up the three. Even though the shot clock really wasn't winding down, it's just Hornsby.
Coverdale had defensive position and Huffman charged, and here's Stan Heath off the bench to scream a protest. Second foul on Huffman.
Huffman told by his coach Heath that he was going to be forced left, but Coverdale getting his body in front just enough. Stan Heath begging for his player there, saying that was, the man was not set, he was moving on the play. Or something like that.
He was, the official did a good job there of calming him down. Heath was about a couple of words from a technical. Scott Thornley was the man who, you know, used really terrific officiating judgment. Jeffries pops from outside. He joins the parade. Raining threes here in Lexington, Kentucky. He's the sixth Hoosier to hit a tray.
Jeffries has that itchy trigger finger right now. He's not getting any catches inside. And when he doesn't, he'll usually drip to the perimeter. And the thing is, he can make those shots.
Mitchell, tough little bank. Gates unable to rebound it. And Shaw, oh, they're banging around, no whistles. Oh, Huffman driving the lane, and he is fouled. Every starter with a three-point shot, Jeffries being the last of the starting five. Then you throw in A.J. Moy, make six. First foul on Jeffries. It's a tournament record for Indiana, most threes they've ever hit in an NCAA tournament game. The previous was 10 against Temple 8 years ago.
And Dick, all of a sudden, the tenor of this whole game has changed here in the second half. As Kent State has come out very, very physical. They're looking for the contact. They're banging into people. And Nate Gerwig is a haymaker pick a little while earlier to try to free up Huffman.
Kent State starting the second half, building on their 8-0 run of the first half, into the first half. Went 12 unanswered points, but now it's the Hoosiers who answer back with a three from Jeffries and a three from Hornsby.
You got four seniors for Kent State who are not going to go down without a fight. They're going to come out battling.
Odell, Hornsby, the leaner, short. Nice rebound by Shaw with one hand.
Good defense there to force Hornsby out of three-point land, where he's had radar, forcing him into the two-point area.
Get him into that uncomfortable 15-foot range.
It is kind of crazy, isn't it?
Coverdale's foul is his second. Tremendous pace of the first 4 minutes of this second half. As Mike Davis, his coach at Alabama, C.M. Newton, also coach here at Kentucky, here cheering him on. And those of you who saw him race after the game against Duke and point to the crowd, he was pointing at Newton just to say, look, coach, I did it. Jeffries against Gates, cuts him off.
Physical inside. Gates and Jeffries battling for position. The officials letting this go so far. And then Gates now has forced Jeffries away from the basket.
Gates giving away 5 inches, but weighing more than his opponent. Nice entry pass.
Odell with the basket. He has five. 15-point lead, Indiana. And these Hoosier fans in there. Some 16,000 of them here in this crowd of 22,000 love this comeback just when Kent State seemed to be building early second half momentum.
Kent State giving it their best shot as far as trying to get physical, playing tough defense, and they've done it a couple of times, and still Indiana has been able to find the basket.
Huffman for three, rattles out. Shaw able to get the rebound, and as he slips down, calls time.
Gonna timeout.
4 minutes and 6 seconds into this second half. A lot of good shots are made when the pass is just right. Indiana by 15. Tonight in Lexington, live aerial coverage of today's game, tonight's game, being provided by the Saturn Lightship. Saturn is proud to be part of CBS's coverage of the NCAA South Regional. For information about the Lightship, you're invited to visit Saturn.com. Indiana, 11 for 13 from three-point range. Kent State, 1 for 8, and that simply has been the story.
Well, Mike Davis and the Indiana Hoosiers, part of the game plan, of course, is to try to slow down Trevor Huffman. He was a big key in Kent State's victory in the first round last year against Indiana, scoring 20 of his 24 points in the second half. So they're working hard on taking the strong hand away from him. Consequently, on the other side, Stan Heath and Kent State, they've got to find a way to get Huffman some better chances. Trevor has to move a little bit more without the basketball, catch it, and get some random little pick-and-roll plays where they come up and set a ball screen for him, because right now he has had to work way too hard in trying to not only find his own shot, but find his teammates. He's too important to this team.
In fact, he's only had 5 shots the entire game, making 2. Coverdale hawking him every bounce of the ball. Gates now, and Fife draws him. Coverdale right up into the jersey. Ooh, Jeffries really physical on Gates.
Yeah, Jeffries comfortable at going out on the perimeter and defending, as well as playing inside.
Eric Hout, number 22, just into the game, a sophomore from Lansing, Michigan. He's a three-point shooter, but his first attempt well short. Timeout.
Whenever you come. Chevy. The cars you can depend on. The cars that last.
You never had to look too far.
Chevy, we'll be there.
Always with you.
In the dust with the Intel Pentium 4 processor.
I have something to tell you.
You first.
No, you go.
I'm not ready to get married.
Okay.
So, what was your news?
I won the lottery.
$63 million.
Think about it this way, man. After taxes, that's only like $28, $30 million.
That's it.
Yeah.
Life is best told over a great-tasting Miller Lite at a place called Miller Time.
Shannon? Hey, it's Steve. What's going on?
Three men will enter a Top Gun training program, witness their incredible story, and see who will fail and who is bound for glory. The new series American Fighter Pilot launches CBS Friday.
37-year-old Stan Heath, his first head coaching job. He was 4-4 at the start. He was going in one direction using the Michigan State system he had learned under Tom Izzo. And, of course, Kent State still working the way they did when Gary Waters, their ex-coach now at Rutgers, had tutored them. And they finally had a big clubhouse meeting and worked it out. No basket. There's no basket. There was an offensive foul underneath. Somebody used an elbow to push away. Mike Davis didn't like that call. Jared Odle has his third. And the other part of the story, he wanted the Michigan State assistant job so bad that he bought a mannequin and cut off one of the arms of the mannequin, mailed it to Tom Izzo and said, I'd give my right arm to be one of your coaches. It got Izzo's attention and he hired him. Not to be recommended. Huffman, tough leaner. Volleyballed around and finally to the seven-footer Edwards to score. 48-35, Indiana.
Now, even though Indiana presents problems on the interior as far as shot block threat, changing some shots, Kent State has to continue to penetrate, continue to attack the basket.
Oh, Gates picked Jeffrey's pocket. Ninth turnover.
And there's that good high pick that should help Huffman, but Dane Fife reading it very nicely, just switching out on Huffman.
But look at Fife out here, away from the ball, right on Huffman, not letting him get more than a step and a half away.
If Indiana's going to get beat, it's not going to be by Trevor Huffman. That's pretty much what Indiana is saying to themselves and saying to Huffman and Kent State.
Nice pass by Gates and Shaw. No foul as Jeffrey's got a piece of it. Shaw thought he was hitting the arm. Coverdale. Fife. That's three-point range. That's Indiana's range. For 14 now for Indiana.
Incredible shooting, and it's obviously so hard to overcome. Kent State is having to work so hard to get just a good look at the basket, and then at the other end, Indiana just able to come down and comfortably launch the three-point shot.
Another miss by Mitchell, and a foul, I believe, against Kent State, pushing for position underneath. Yes, it goes against Edwards, his second.
Well, Dane Fife went in danger of joining the ranks of Ralph Branca and Bill Buckner had Jason Williams been able to knock down that free throw and tie the game up in regulation. It's bounced back beautifully. He said he was even feeling, even after the win against Duke, he did not sleep well. He was
he had nightmares.
So upset with himself. So
he said he kept thinking, what if he'd have made it? I'd been such a goat. Would they have let me back at Indiana?
the freshman Perry, Donald Perry from Tallulah, Louisiana. He was a Mr. Louisiana basketball the year after Chris Duhon of Duke in that state. Down to six on the shot clock. Hornsby firing from three-point range short, but it becomes a good pass. And the first points for Jeff Newton, the 6'9 junior from Atlanta. Gates outside. Oh, for a big man, he has such a sweet shot.
And Antonio Gates has to do a little bit of that, especially with Jared Jeffries on him. Take him outside a little bit because he can knock down those baseline jumpers. And then when he draws Jeffries, then he can put it on the floor, possibly get some three-point opportunities.
Another player hits the deck, it's Fife.
Anybody around Antonio Gates has a good chance of hitting the deck.
Hornsby, he has zeroed in. Kyle Hornsby, 14 points.
And Stan Heath just continues to roll his eyes and shake his head. As right now, he and his ball club caught in a buzzsaw with this three-point accuracy.
Gates, he's just the only one who's giving Stan Heath of Kent State any points. And he now leads all players with 15.
And there's a part of Kent State that has to be thinking, well, how long can they continue to keep making these threes? And you know, all of a sudden you start missing threes, they can turn into long rebounds that can turn into fast breaks going the other way.
Hornsby 4-for-5 from outside the arc with the ball. Fife is 3-for-3 and Coverdale 3-for-4. Unbelievable shooting. Fife.
I mean, if Kent State, the defense went over and sat on the bench and just let him shoot those unguarded, they couldn't do any better than this.
If you had five chairs out there, it would be a lot tougher to make a three.
14 out of 17 from three-point range. The sharp shooting Hoosiers lead by 20.
You're going to New York.
Uh-huh.
And McDonald's is paying for it?
Yeah.
And you'll get hamburgers?
Uh-huh.
All because you're a good basketball player?
Yeah.
See ya.
Coming in April to Madison Square Garden, McDonald's introduces the very first Girls All-American High School basketball game. Don't miss it.
Chevy Tahoe is the only large SUV with the security of AutoTrack four-wheel drive, so you can impress people. Or avoid them altogether. Chevy Tahoe, like a rock.
Last week, Survivor was the most watched show. CBS Thursday, be there for the seafood buffet. Plus, one tribe gets raided.
Wow.
And everyone's getting island fever.
Living out here in Survivor 4.
All new Survivor, back on CBS Thursday at 8, 7 Central.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by American Express, Microsoft, Midas, and by SEMA.
Not much traffic on a Saturday night in Lexington. They love their basketball. Nighttime is over. It's a new day, this. Well, that's been the theme, and I think the pressure off the shoulders of 44-year-old Mike Davis that finally this is his Indiana team, and the fans are happy that he's there. Tournament record for most threes, that great Loyola Marymount team of a few years ago.
When they were taking about 120 shots a game.
Dimitri Shaw inside to score for Kent State. again, Indiana. 2-for-10 against Duke from outside. 14-for-17 tonight. And away from the ball, the hold. They go against Eric Thomas of Kent State. His first, and with it a timeout. We're at the midpoint of the second half. Indiana by 18.
Whenever you call me, whenever you want me, I'll be there. Whenever you need me, I'll be around.
Chevy, the cars you can depend on, the cars that last.
You never had to look too far.
Chevy, we'll be there.
Always with you.
At Midas, all we think about is auto care. In fact, recently, I had an idea for a kids show, a way to get kids excited about our business.
Wave hello to Mr. AC!
Hi, Mr. AC!
Mr. AC is very cold. The compressor pressurizes the... We're still tweaking it.
Midas, we do that.
All around the world, Siemens is energizing the cities and towns we live in. We engineer new ways to efficiently generate, distribute, and use power. And by providing energy to people everywhere, we're giving them the power to live better.
Hold the pickles, hold the lettuce. Special orders now, you know they don't upset us.
At Rupp Arena, Indiana, leading 59-41. If you took just their three-point makes, they would be leading 42-41. It has been, the word that comes to mind is ridiculous, the three-point shooting.
Wow, Kyle Hornsby, even Jared Jeffries getting into the mix, and Dane Fife as well. Indiana was 9-for-11 from downtown in the first half. And I said maybe they shouldn't fall in love with that three in the second half. They're shooting it better now, 5-for-6.
For the game, they're shooting 82% of their three-point attempts. I mean, they beat any team in the country if you shoot like this. They were only 2-for-10 against Duke and beat the number one team in the country.
You know, it's one of the things that can give a lower seed team a chance against anybody, the great equalizer, if you can get hot from three-point land. But I don't think anybody in this tournament has even been close.
Coverdale, who is hot, favoring a bad ankle, and he may have twisted it again. And as you look ahead to the Final Four, should Indiana continue to be successful here tonight, that could be critical to their cause.
And keep an eye on the left ankle. Stepped right on Eric Thomas's left foot. And the churn there.
And wouldn't you know, it would be the left foot. Not the right foot, the healthy. No, it's going to always be the bad ankle. Coverdale with 14 points, 3-for-4 on his threes. And he ran into Dunleavy of Duke and aggravated it on Thursday night.
And again, he told us the day after the Duke game that it was still very sore because of that particular injury, and it's always a re-injury of that sore ankle. And however, in today's game, it looked like he was coming back to his normal gait.
Didn't practice yesterday, was not sound enough to even practice with his team in the workout yesterday. You can see him holding it in midair, he knew. And they're going to help him right back to the locker room. He's not only the guy that runs the show, you could that he has defensively when he made that play in the first half. He is the player that stirs the Indiana pot.
Yeah, he's the junior right in between the seniors, Dane Fife and Kyle Hornsby, but they play off each other so well.
Boy,
with a big hand of Jeff Newton in his face. Antonio Gates still up for the easy shot, and the fight is going to be called for the foul. Indiana fans don't like it.
Yeah, that's a good call. That's a good call. And Dane Fife has gone to the well maybe once or twice too often. He's flopping earlier in this game, and this time he clearly pulled the defender into him.
Hornsby out. A.J. Moye is on the floor for Indiana, as is Donald Perry. Gates, oh, he takes Newton right off his feet, but then loses the ball, but it was last touched by Indiana. And there goes Coverdale being carried back to the locker room. But here at Rupp Arena, that's a pretty good distance from the playing court.
This is a tough cover for Jeff Newton on Antonio Gates, especially away from the basket.
Huffman, and he switched, and there's Jeffries in his face.
Now he should be able to take Jeffries off the dribble.
Thomas hanging in midair.
What a tip by Shaw. He's only 6'3", and he beat Indiana's height to bat home his sixth point.
Now Kent State extend apply more pressure, and why not? You got the floor leader for Indiana in the locker room with a bad ankle, so the ball handling certainly won't be as sharp, and the floor leadership won't be there.
Coverdale was injured last year in the game in San Diego, and that's why in the second half, Indiana felt that Kent State really took advantage of his absence. And a timeout call by Perry just as he was about to be tied up. Timeout with 8:22 left.
Weeds in 24 hours. The leading imitator doesn't. Roundup knocks out weeds in 24 hours.
Well, a reminder, fans, beginning April 11th, CBS Sports proudly presents again a tradition unlike any other, the Masters. Defending champion Tiger Woods heads the superstar lineup expected at historic Augusta National. Game five, Huffman on him. With 1 second on the shot clock, he missed the rim, so that's a violation. Kent State the other way. And the fans in yellow stand trying to spur their team to a comeback.
They sense something right now. They see that Indiana is at loose ends without Coverdale out there. You got a freshman, Donald Perry, will be playing point guard right now. The pressure should increase from the Golden Flashes.
No basket. Gates was fouled by Moye. Harmon, what do you have for us?
Dick, the immediate update on Tom Coverdale is he was carried not only off the floor, but all the way into the training room where he is now getting x-rays, and it does not look good purely from a visual sighting. Back to you.
All right, thanks, Harmon. Inside, but unable to hit Gates, and he battles and comes up with it on the second chance. What an athlete, Antonio Gates from Detroit, played at Central High School. He was number two Mr. Michigan basketball to Dana Fife his senior year. Led his team to the state title in basketball, but better known for football. And 10-second violation. So the freshman Perry unable to get the ball across midcourt and the required 10 seconds and a timeout. And there's some hope for the Kent State fans at 59-47.
Thanks.
Michelob Light.
There you go, baby. The great taste of Michelob Light makes any occasion seem...
Estimated Americans overpaid $311 million in taxes. That was $610 for each taxpayer. That $610 could have been yours. Now H&R Block will double-check last year's tax return free. We can refile past returns. You could get more money back.
Dennis got a great defense. $1 million.
Not interested.
Dennis, I just talked to the chip people, and because you're you, they say $2 million.
What did I just say, Sam?
No, I know, right, sorry. I got them up to 2.5 mil, and there's no eating of the chips. You look at them.
For the last time, I don't do ads, all right?
No, you shouldn't.
And that's final.
That I know, you're right.
Done.
Exactly. I'll tell them, maybe.
20 years now, where they go? 20 years, I don't know. I sit and I wonder sometimes where they've gone.
He's an elbow man.
My boy.
Generation after generation, it's good to have someone you can depend on.
Augusta National celebrates the 100th birthday of the man behind the mystique, the legendary Bobby Jones. A tradition unlike any other, the Masters on CBS.
Check in our tournament summary. Oklahoma first to the dance. Congratulations to the number 2 seed Sooners. And Oregon has won 3 in a row in the tournament, first time since they were the first ever national champions back in 1939. They go against Kansas tomorrow, Connecticut and Maryland. More great action here on CBS in the regional finals. Huffman inside, a great pass and a foul by Fife. Suddenly, without Coverdale, Kent State has scored 6 unanswered points.
Beautiful setup that time by the Golden Flashes, spreading the floor for Huffman. He knows he's going to get forced to his left hand, but he's got that drive into the lane. But what Kent State was able to do to spread out, get the two big guys, Jared Jeffries and Jeffrey Newton, away from the basket so Huffman could create.
Shaw hits the free throw. Armin?
Dick, the latest on Tom Coverdale is he will not return to this game. He's quote-unquote in a tremendous amount of pain and has been given some pain medicine at this point in time. Back to you.
All right, thank you. Well, that's not good news for Indiana looking ahead and now looking to right it to this moment. 8 straight points without him in the lineup, and the pressure is on from Kent State.
A 5 scrappy defense out there. Oh, my!
Which way they're going to call it? Against the blocker. It'll go against Kent State. Mitchell thought he had drawn the charging foul.
Stanley's not really complaining, applauding the effort of Mitchell here. And Mitchell doesn't really complain on this. Now, he is clearly moving over there. Good call by the official. But the freshman, Donald Perry, he looks a little bit out of sorts right now. With 5 tough defenders out there for Kent State, you want another guy to handle the ball. Jeffrey's not bad, but Eric Thomas will battle you too, so this is not an easy job.
There's a hand on it from Huffman, and there's a backcourt violation, although Huffman touched the ball. That shouldn't be. Huffman forced the ball in the backcourt.
Yeah, that was touched, and that's what Mike Davis is saying. Here to definitely be a deflection, and there was.
Hornsby
touches it,
Coverdale
but he never really had control of the basketball. That was a loose ball. That's not a good call.
A 10-point game. Indiana's 20-point lead whittled away as Kent State taking advantage of the absence of Tom Coverdale. And another hoop by Antonio Gates. What a game he's had again. 21 to lead all scorers. It's an 8-point lead.
And the Kent State effort has quieted the Indiana crowd, and here they go again.
Gates with a steal. He takes it against Perry, and Perry had to foul him. Oh, this crowd, especially across the way for Kent State, is in a roar.
There's Gates with a little hesitation, and then that finesse game that he has, the little fadeaway. And at 6'5", about 265, that's unbelievable quickness, able to get out in the passing lane and go, not coast to coast, but three-quarter court. And then he was hacked on the play, showing the strength he had to still get that shot up at the basket.
You can see him, though, that effort. He's barely able to grab his breath. This man has 4'6", 4'5", 5 speed. They say he'll play tight end 1 year of eligibility in football for Kent State. and bounces that one home. That's an 11-0 run for Kent State without Coverdale on the floor for Indiana.
He's playing like an outside linebacker right now, reading the quarterback's eyes.
Ooh, almost another steal.
Oh, now Indiana, nobody really seems to want the ball, or they don't really know how they want to get into any kind of offense right now. Somebody's got to take charge out there.
Jeffries turns down a three.
Oh, again, Kyle Hornsby, just when, no, it's Fyke. Dan Fyke, just when the Hoosiers need it most of all. And Dan Fyke delivers, he has 15.
When in trouble, why not go back to the play that has worked all night? Launch the three.
15 out of 19 now as Gates is fouled. Oh. No, traveling is the call. Took an extra bounce before he went up for the shot.
Antonio Gates showing a lot of poise right there. That was a good tough move, getting the defender in the air. Not really sure if he shuffled those feet jumping into the defender.
And Gates almost stumbling as he was defending Newton, fell into him. Team fouls now. That'll be the sixth on Kent State. Indiana's committed seven, so Kent State in the bonus, and from now on both teams will go to the line.
Even though Fyke was able to get that last three, Indiana has been unable to basically break the plane of the free throw line except maybe one time in the last five or six possessions.
10-point lead. The high pass into Jeffries. Blocked. It was Thomas who got a hand on it. This is Thomas at the other end. Around Newton. Oh, beautiful block by Jeffries of Indiana. Almost thrown away by Perry. There's Jeffries at the other end. Let's slam it home. You can hear the cries of relief from the Indiana fans. That 3-by-5 and that jam getting the Hoosiers back to 12-point lead.
And it hasn't been pretty or smooth, but a terrific job by Jeffries getting out of the pack and beating everybody down the floor to finally get an easy basket.
Thomas for three. He's short. Jeffries has it batted away, and Huffman feeds Mitchell. Mitchell with a bank. And it's back to a 10-point lead for the Hoosiers. We have 4:44 left.
Kent State right now trying to just scramble in the backcourt, looking to trap, looking to double team. Just trying to get any kind of a deflection. They feel that they've got Indiana on the run, despite the fact that Indiana just scored 5 points in the last minute.
Fyke and Shaw bats it away from him. The clock, 15 seconds on the shot clock. Here's end-to-end. Jeffries blocks at one end and then hustles to the other to score.
He's a terrific effort all night long defensively, getting out ahead of the pack. He's not having a typical Jared Jeffries offensive game, but certainly putting forth a terrific effort defensively.
9 points for Jeffries. Newton! Nice move by the big junior. He has 4 points.
Stan Heath with his ball club right now. They look exhausted out there. They've expended a lot.
Mitchell for three.
They are working so hard at the defensive end. I'm a little surprised Mitchell is able to have the legs to get that shot up.
Let's see if that sparks him into a better shooting touch. He was 0 for 16 from three-point land in the last one. And Perry, he did that against Duke when he came off the bench. Able to work his way with a dribble right through the defense.
Yeah, now Kent State having all kinds of problems bending their knees and moving their legs.
Huffman, Newton up high for the rebound. 3.5 minutes left. 3.5 minutes. And the road to the Final Four will go to Atlanta for one of these two teams.
Looks like Jeffrey is almost going to be the primary ball handler right now, other than the point guard Donald Perry, because right now Eric Thomas not putting the kind of pressure on him that he needs to.
Down to 7 on the shot clock. And finally, Jeffries.
How did the ball get inside there to Fyke?
Actually, it was going out of bounds, and a headlong dive by Kyle Hornsby to save it.
Fyke with 17. The block by Newton. His presence defensively has been key to this comeback for Indiana. When it appeared Kent State had him in trouble, and Hornsby answers again.
they see through the stockings?
How do they see through the stockings? They're sheer.
Right.
But you're missing the point of the story. The woman's car is commandeered, stranding her miles from the nearest FedEx location.
She's toast?
No. Directly across the street, her salvation.
Directly across the street?
Technically, it was Kitty Corner, but stay with me. Is it a mirage?
I don't know.
Is it a miracle?
Yes.
No. It's one of thousands of FedEx Express drop boxes strategically located at post office locations coast to coast.
Keeping the engines of commerce
well-lubed. Precisely.
How does your gray beard or mustache reflect on you?
Man, I look old.
Get vitamin-enriched Just for Men gel. The Rejuvenator, specially made to penetrate coarse gray in 5 minutes and match your hair. The Rejuvenator, Just for Men gel.
We now take you to Schlotzky's.
Albuquerque turkey.
It's marvelous.
Albuquerque turkey.
Kyle Hornsby in the corner is going to get an earned pass from Jarrett Jeffries, but able to track it down and make just a desperation save right into the hands to Dane Fife, who finally gets something other than a three-point shot.
Coverdale, bittersweet for him, out of the game, and one wonders if he'll be able to play in Atlanta, but cheering on his teammates. And Fife and Hornsby on that last collaboration. Now leading the Hoosiers, Fife with 17, Hornsby 16, Coverdale before being hurt, 14 points for him. Kent State had pulled within seven at 59-52 with 6.5 to go, but back come the Hoosiers. And it's been Kyle Hornsby who has sparked them at the offensive end.
And it was a tremendous defensive effort by Kent State. And there's Andrew Mitchell getting into the lane. But also an even better effort on the part of Indiana to at least hang on to the basketball without their floor leader, Tom Coverdale, and withstand that rush.
And it shows some of this Indiana depth when Newton comes in and had a couple of big defensive plays, blocks and rebounds. Our CBS Sportsline stat of the game, three-point field goals. Surprise? 1-for-10 for the Golden Flashes. But what's really been golden has been Indiana, 15-for-19. Get complete tournament coverage at cbs.sportsline.com or on America Online, enter keyword CBS Sportsline.
That's a good point, Dick, about Jeff Newton. I think he's the wild card for this team, a key guy coming off the bench. A rebounding presence, a shot-blocking presence, give you a couple points inside. He picked up two quick fouls in the first half, couldn't get involved.
And he gets the rebound there off the missed free throw.
Well, he got huge rebounds against Duke on Thursday night.
Bedford, and he reached in, picked up the foul. Jeffries.
This Indiana team showing a remarkable amount of poise without their best point guard on the floor in Tom Coverdale. Donald Perry, as a freshman, a little bit shaky out there, but all the upperclassmen kind of holding him together. Just the coach is talking to him right now.
Back comes Eric Thomas as Bedford goes out, and Jeffries to the line. He grew up in the shadow of the campus towers of Bloomington, Indiana, North High School, just near the IU campus. He was a big Michigan fan as a kid, he said, at Chris Webber and that Fab Five team. Never thought about going to Ann Arbor. And Huffman has to hold Perry after the steal. Third foul on Huffman. Oh my, tomorrow March Madness continues. What a doubleheader. Oregon's Ducks, number two, against number one Kansas in the Midwest final. And then UConn, number two, against number one Maryland in the East. Winners will take their place among the Final Four. Action begins with a road to the Final Four presented by UPS. 2 o'clock Eastern, 11 o'clock for those of you watching in the West.
Nick, when you think back to last year for Trevor Huffman and Kent State in the second round, after beating Indiana, he had a very poor game, 2-for-11 against Cincinnati.
Andrew Mitchell finding that three-point range. It's down to an 11-point lead, but only 1:40 left. Yeah, Cincinnati really tied him up defensively in that second round game, and Indiana defended him.
Exactly.
A good game
I think
plan.
That was pretty much what Indiana felt going in. He is such an important part to the team. It should take nothing away from the absolutely fabulous career that Trevor Huffman has had at Kent State. It's almost, he can wear it a little bit as a badge of honor. He won't. He's too much of a competitor that Indiana pretty much geared up a large chunk of their defensive effort in taking him out of this game, not letting him beat them.
Perry 0 for 3 from the line. And Huffman, you know his story, out of Little Petoskey, Michigan, in the northwest of the Lower Peninsula. Only one high school in town. No one wanted him. Last scholarship available in the summer for Kent State. He takes it. He's the all-time leading scorer now in the school's history. Perry, one out of two on that trip. One out of four in the game. With 1 minute, 34 seconds left. Indiana, 73. Kent State, 61.
Look, Enterprise Rent-A-Car.
Ellie's renting again.
And Enterprise picked her up again.
She said Enterprise picks her up free.
Free?
Free.
Now that makes renting easy.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Training Day. Buy it on video and DVD. The Detective.
Today's a training day, Officer Hoyt.
The Rookie.
I will do anything you want me to do.
Let the training begin. Academy Award nominees Denzel Washington and Ethan Hawke. Training Day. Buy it on video and DVD.
Boom!
Take all the time you want, folks.
We'll take this one in red.
Beautiful choice, sir.
No. Black.
Black.
That's actually my favorite color.
Red. Definitely red.
When software lets you quickly give customers what they want, that's one degree of separation. That's business with .NET from Microsoft.
Lexington with a reminder later tonight, CBS, the place for great drama, starting with The Agency. Special night followed by Saturday's number one drama, The District. It's all here tonight on CBS. 73-61 Indiana by 12, with a minute and a half remaining. No timeouts left for Kent State. And Coverdale won't be able to be active in the celebration should Indiana win.
Well, it's been a miserable three-point shooting night for Kent State. Just 2 for 11. But if they're going to get back in this, they're going to have to fire away now.
Huffman, and stepping into him was Perry as he cut off his path, and Huffman down heavily. Executive producer of CBS Sports is Terry Ewert. Coordinating producer of NCAA Basketball, Bob Dekus. Today's game produced by Bob Monsbach, directed by Larry Cavallina. Senior producer of Singular at the Half, Eric Mann, directed by Bob Matina. Coordinating producer of CBS Sports, Harold Bryant. Associate director of today's game, Andy Goldberg. Sideline producer, Michael Pierce. Broadcast associate, Ryan Galvin. The technical manager is Rick Godwin. Technical director, Norm Patterson. And in audio, Phil Adler, and statistician, Butch Bear. Thanks to all you men and women. It's been a terrific Thursday night and Saturday night here in Lexington, Kentucky. Huffman makes the first. And with this good pull, Kent State within 10. He has 8 points in the game.
And you would expect tons of pressure here from Kent State. Go for a steal, quick foul.
Oh, Mitchell got his hand on it. This senior group for Kent State has won 100 games. Matches the best ever in their conference record. They've won 21 in a row prior to tonight. That was a record. And no team has won 30 games in a season in MAC conference history, and no MAC conference team has ever won three games in the tournament to make it to the Elite Eight. Ohio did it back in 64 when they had to win only two games. Foul on Fife is fourth.
Mitchell off the block.
And Gary Waters, now the coach of Rutgers, who recruited these four seniors, deserves a lot of credit, along with Stan Heath, for bringing these guys in here. And these players and Stan Heath deserve a lot of credit for making the compromises and concessions to come together as a team early on when they were just 4-4.
There's the confirmation of what an outstanding season and tremendous 4 years it's been for this Kent State Golden Flashes team. They have put their program on the basketball map.
And the people in Northeast Ohio at Kent State can be very proud. And I think around the country, they've captured the hearts and imagination of a lot of people doing such a terrific job in this tournament as the 10th seed.
Yeah, that was a great line by their coach, Stan Heath, said it first. We said, hey, we're insulted by this Cinderella tag. We're better than that. And then he used that psychological play to say, hey, let's think about who Cinderella was. Did all the dirty work, got no credit, found a way to get to the dance, and then she won the prince. Hey, maybe it's not so bad.
Well, their coaches always find a way to spin it in a positive light. Stan Heath did a nice job of it.
Perry makes that one. He's 2 for 5 from the line, 4 points for him.
Dane Pfeiffer over on the bench with assistant coach Ben McDonald in a very animated discussion right now.
Didn't want to come out of the game, and Davis was barking at him. Gates fires from three-point range, short. And Perry got the rebound, fouled by Shaw.
And one of the things Ben McDonald could be saying to Dane Pfeiffer is, hey, look at our buddy Tom Coverdale down there. He's got the bad ankle.
But Pfeiffer is so competitive. He's the one who fouled Jason Williams on that three-point shot, the only way Duke could possibly have come back, and it gave him a four-point play. He said, he's a coach's son. He said, I've seen a lot of dumb plays. He said, that was idiotic.
Well, again,
fire in his eyes.
You know, Mike Davis's coach came a little bit in and out, as I did too. He's co-defensive player of the year. He's a defensive-minded guy. As a player, you're trained to get after people, to challenge shots. You know, and it's people have said, well, you got to think, you got to concentrate. You can't think and concentrate a lot of times when you're playing basketball. You react to situations. That's why you practice all the time.
No one blocked out Perry, but Huffman comes up with the ball anyway. Dimitri Shaw with a quick three. It won't go. And there's Antonio Gates to bat home another. What a game for Gates.
1 minute
exactly left in the game, and another foul. Made that last basket to Thomas. He has four. It was Thomas that's credited with a goal. As Tom Coverdale icing down that painful left ankle injury, the one that has bothered him throughout the tournament. 76-67. Clock about to strike midnight for Kent State.
Going back to another point on Dane Pfeiffer, that's not to say I'm excusing that foul in that situation when you're up four, but you can understand the kind of guy, that the kind of player that Dane Pfeiffer is.
Our Chevrolet players of the game tonight, Antonio Gates with 22 points and 7 rebounds, has been fabulous throughout this tournament, and Dane Pfeiffer, a defensive demon, working against Huffman, 17 points for Indiana. Another miss by Perry. There'll be teams that will note that as Indiana makes plans for Atlanta. Mitchell way outside. Newton with a rebound. Hornsby, can he save this one? No, it hit the baseline. And with 47 seconds, Kent State gets another chance.
And Kyle Hornsby's shaking up on the play. Looked like he banged his right hip. And that's the second time that we've seen him just give up his body to try to save the ball.
Huffman working along the baseline, comes out to Thomas for three. Rebound, Jeffries, and Huffman has to foul him. 37 seconds left, and now the Indiana fans rise as one. They know what's ahead, the Final Four invitation.
Well, the three perimeter players for Indiana have been brilliant from the opening tip. If it wasn't the three-point shooting, it was their solid defense on the perimeter, doing a great job on Trevor Huffman, and hustle plays like that. Hornsby, Fife, Coverdale do an outstanding job. And if Indiana is going to make any noise in the Final Four, Nick, I think Tom Coverdale has to make a very, very quick recovery by next week.
And meantime, Matt, it's that moment where the senior comes out for the last time. Dimitri Shaw, the first one taken out by Stan Heath. 35 seconds left. 10-point lead, Indiana. A.J. Moy on Huffman. Mitchell weaving inside to score two. 26 seconds. Moy fouled by Huffman, and that will be all for Trevor Huffman. You know he'll get a tremendous reaction from the fans who have cheered his record-setting shooting. While at Kent State, well over 1,800 points in his terrific career.
Trevor Huffman being hugged by his teammates.
You don't want to go. Mother Jennifer down from Petoskey, Michigan. She's the one who said when he didn't get a scholarship, honey, maybe you're only a Division II player. Well, he's proven the whole world he's much more than that. And his heart is in his eyes now.
And none of these players or the coaching staff or the fans of Kent State have to hang their head about anything. They just got hit in the beginning of this game with a barrage of threes early on, eight in a row, and it just put the Golden Flashes right on their heels and onto the ropes, and they battled back, made a terrific run midway through this second half, but that's a tremendous amount of points from three-point land to try to overcome.
A.J. Moy at the line. Mike Davis hasn't talked to Bob Knight since he took the job at Indiana, and yet he yesterday credited Knight for teaching him detail how to come up with a game plan, and didn't he have a beauty defensively tonight? And that opening barrage of threes, the key tonight. Mitchell off the mark, rebound, Moyer, he's fouled, down to 15 seconds. And now the Indiana players can salute their crowd as they acknowledge the support tonight.
Dane Fife pointing to the Indiana band, congratulating to him. As Mike Davis says, he is a loose cannon and at times a little bit crazy, but I love him. I love that attitude, putting up the four fingers, no doubt, what he's referring to come next week.
Well, that pizza's going to taste great at the old English hut there on the off the campus of Bloomington, Indiana tonight.
Now, how do you know that?
Made a visit once or twice.
I'll bet.
15 seconds from the Final Four. Indiana, it's been 10 years for the Hoosiers and their fans. That's an eternity for this storied program with five national titles. Hout can't hit. Jeffries rebounds. No foul this time. They can count them off. Indiana goes to Atlanta. The long shot in the Final Four, the number five seed. All the others will be ones or twos. One of them, the University of Oklahoma, the number two seed that defeated Missouri. And just as they had to battle to fight off the number 12 seed Tigers, so it was tonight. Indiana had that wonderful, easy, big early lead shooting threes, but right down to 6.5 minutes to go, this game was in doubt. That's the story in Lexington, Kentucky. We'll talk with the coaches and players. Greg Gumbel, right after we pause for this word.